Quick tutorial for today, we're going to talk about one-click audio effect inside Premiere Pro that will reduce your room echo. So I'll move myself a bit further from the mic. Currently, mic is this far away from my mouth, and closer the mic to your subject, less echoey it will be, and the quality of the audio will be nicer. So here is my voice with the echo inside, and here is my voice with the effect applied, and hopefully you cannot hear any echo. The first thing that you need is a good pair of headphones to monitor your audio once you apply the effect. Here we are in Premiere Pro, and the first thing that you need to do is to go to the effect panels and search for D-Reverb, grab it and drag it to your clip. Basically, we're done. But there is a possibility to tweak it. To do that, go to the Effect Controls tab and go down to see the Reverb effect and hit Edit. In order to tweak it accurately, we can loop a portion of the clip so it will play repetitively, so we can concentrate on our audio effect instead of dragging the playhead here and there. Go to the beginning of the clip and hit I, which is going to create in point. Go a bit forward and hit O, and that will going to create out point. Then up here, you're going to click on this plus icon and add loop playback if you don't have it there for some reason. Now, if the loop playback is active once I hit play, Premiere is going to play that portion of the clip that we selected over and over again, and that will help us to hear the audio when we're tweaking the effect. So we can see by default D-Reverb comes with 40%, which is good starting point. From there, if we need, we will gradually increase the percentage and we will monitor our audio while doing that. Remember not to crank that thing to 100, because your audio will sound strange and it will contain strange artifacts. The key here is to listen and increase it gradually. Also, one more useful tip, just turn on and off your effect, just check your before and after to make sure that things are not getting weird. Oh, and there's one more option here, which I do not touch, and leave it on all frequencies, because you have to know exact frequencies you want to affect. I'm not a pro in this audio stuff, and for that reason, I'm leaving it on to all frequencies. Oh, and last thing, in order to clear your in and out points, right click here and click on clear my in and out points. There you have it, another trick that you can use to improve your videos. We'll catch you in the next one. Till then, stay awesome.